Greetings and welcome to the Open to Source Tech Zone, where tonight we are working on installing some individually addressable strip lighting above our workbench here. Well, actually where you can't see right now, but we'll see later. And so, the first step into making that happen is to turn on the soldering station and solder the connector to the strip. Let's do that. Turn the soldering station up to around 400 degrees. Wait for it to warm up. And let's get our solder ready while it's doing that. What we're gonna do is just pre-tin this. Just see if we can make it so you can see it a little bit better. Eventually, I'm gonna get camera set up, one over the workbench here, so that you can be able to see exactly what I'm doing. For now, this works, and I can just describe things a little bit. I'm gonna see if maybe we can adjust the brightness. Turn the brightness down and maybe we'll be able to see a little bit better about what's going on the workbench there. And we'll see. So the soldering iron is now heated up, so we'll just pre-tin it. And then pre-tin these little connections here. Hand is not super steady this time. Okay. Okay, so now those are pre-tinned. Then we'll install our connector on there, starting with the ground and working our way down. Boom. That part's done. So, once we have that, then the next step is we can cut it to the length that we want. So to do that, stand this up here. It will stay. Grab a little piece of tape right here. And this part, let's see if I can shine the light over this. Over here so I can see what it looks like live. And if there's anyone watching, feel free to say hello in the chat. So that looks okay, but I'm just gonna adjust the camera settings to turn the brightness up a bit. Just a bit so you can see a little bit more of what I'm doing down there. And that's good. This little piece of tape to hold the strip down to the ground so I can measure and cut it. So I'm gonna need the scissors over at that end, so I'll leave them there. And the idea here is I'm just gonna line them up kind of side by side, and then hopefully when I go to cut them, they'll line up. There'll be no question about where it should be cut. Okay, so that feels pretty good. Let's just want to do one more just to be safe. There's one right here.
Excellente!
Okay, next step. We unroll the lights. Oh, hey, there's a couple people watching. Right on. Hey guys, how's it going, Logan and Samantha? Let's. So, for you who have just tuned in, we are currently laying out the lights that we will install above the workbench. And these are individually addressable LED strip lighting. And these ones are of the red, green, blue variety. So that means that each of these individual LEDs on here, and there's 60 of them per meter, can be controlled via microcontrollers. And I like to use these little programmable microcontrollers that are Wi-Fi enabled, known as ESP8266. Pretty cool, nifty little things. So, how's it going out there, guys? Let me know in the chat. Now that that is cut, the next step is to probably adhere it to the bottom of the shelf. I would think. Now for this step, move it from the ground. This one up, put it up first. Get up there. I have to use a stool. If you guys can hear me, if it sounds okay, but again. So there's that one up there. And I'm just gonna move this camera for now. So you can see up there a little more. So that, you see that shelf there? That's where I'm gonna be installing the lights. So, I want to install them along the underside of that. So before I do, I'm just gonna quickly wipe it down. This is really quite superficial. It's probably recommended to sand, make it nice and pretty smooth, but not too smooth. We'll find out. So, I'm basically gonna wanna do mirror top and bottom. That looks about right, something like that. I like the same amount on each side. Hey Greg! Whoa! Good to see you out there. I like what you do with the live stream and stuff. Yeah, so let's move right along. So we got the strip lights along the top now. Those ones are easy because we can just stick them and just like place them up there. These ones are gonna be a little different because I want to use the adhesive that comes with them. And I've had mixed results with this adhesive that comes with these things. Sometimes it works pretty good for certain applications, for certain materials, and other times it doesn't stick so well. But we're gonna find out. You know, just do it how we do, right? Right. Okay. See how that looks. Give me some light. See. Okay. So let's climb up here again. And try and figure out how we're gonna do this. So I guess the first thing to do would be to flip the whole strip. Nice, the sound is fine. Awesome. Thanks for that confirmation. And if you can hear the music at all, this is a Creative Commons music that's released with somewhat open licensing. So it's free to share and use for whatever sort of purposes that you might want. There may be some restrictions. This particular song that is playing is called Home by Noxive. And I really dig it. All the songs that they're playing and have been playing are played off YouTube, off of Argo Fox channel. And yeah, it's good music. This is a chill out mix, and I really like it. And I'm stoked to like seek out and find more Creative Commons music with open licensing. So if any of you guys watching now or later have any good suggestions for free open Creative Commons music, please let me know. You don't have to, I mean, like, do what you want, but it'd be cool, I would dig. Anywho, moving right along, I've got the end of this lifted up. Now, could get my stapler ready, and then staple this end up, and then just peel the adhesive back as I place it. And I think that should do the trick. I think that's what we want to do. So, let's just try that. Let's get it started. You can see the arrows right there. So, put the staple in there. And hopefully, I can staple this. Just so that it doesn't go through it. It goes beside it. But in my experience, kind of went through it, but in my experience, oftentimes that doesn't matter. So we're gonna find out, because it only went through one, not like rigid connection or anything. Okay, so that's stapled in, and hopefully it's, you know what? Relatively even on each end, so it's about that far away. I need to go over here and sort of. Yeah, it's about even. A little off, but whatevs. So, now I'm just peeling the adhesive back and sort of. Trying to keep it in a straight line-ish, and sort of tacking it up as I go. Having troubles seeing what the straight line is. Well, I can tell already it's not. So hopefully I won't just mess that up. I'll just keep. Maybe I should have put it right up against the edge, but this is good. So, continue. Just peeling the adhesive back and moving along. And it's just sort of sticking to it. Adhesive is doing its job, which is great. And you know, something I just realized that I could have done is test this thing before I like adhere it and sort of set it in sort of stone, or not stone, but getting a little off track here, so I can sort of see. So you don't really want to be doing that too much. You're taking the adhesive off and putting it back. And I think, you know, it's all about a balance between getting it perfect. I mean, like, obviously you can't ever get anything perfect, but like, you know, you want to get it as good as you can, but then like, there's always imperfections. And so what I've am constantly learning is that it's always about a balance. just allowing things to be sometimes. Just be as they are. It may not be exactly as you wanted or envisioned initially or what have you. But it always seems to work out in the end. Except for here. It's a little off. Now I just want to readjust. Just a bit. There we go. So it can still make it past there. There we go. Now we have strip lights installed along the bottom edge there, which is pretty cool. And you might think, okay, cool. Strip lights are up. You're done. Well, sort of, but it's not exactly done. It will work like this, and actually we'll plug it in and see that it works. But there is one addition that just really, really just makes it nice. So I'll just plug this in. This is a 5-volt, 3-amp power supply. Probably a little insufficient for this application, but we're not going to be putting straight white through there, like have to, so plug it in, and hopefully, fingers crossed, it works. Moment of truth. Oh, and they all work. They all light up. Beautiful. That's awesome. I'm stoked on that. That's cool that that's working. I noticed that the stream quality could be a little bit better. I had some settings that were better last time, and I'm gonna have to go back to that. And then I just noticed at that moment that it just completely froze. So I'm wondering if it's this switch that I have installed. Anyways, yeah, let's see. I wonder if I can change the bitrate while it's... Yeah. Well, unfortunately I can't change the settings while it's streaming, and it seems to be going okay right now. So I'm just going to kind of leave it at that, and then, yeah, we'll fix it later. So it's working. It looks pretty cool. But you can't really see from that angle, but like at the angle that I'm at, I'll just quickly show you. I can't even get quite, but you can see the lights, and I don't like that. I just want to see the reflection. I don't want to see the lights. So in order to combat that, we got this, which is just like a big stick that we're gonna stick in front of it, and that will cover up the lights. And biggity shabam, it should work. It should look cool. I think it'll work. So first step to do that is turn the light back on here. And just give this a quick little sort of wipe off. It's really rough on the back here, but I don't really mind because it is the back. There is a couple nails sticking in here. Those I'll probably take out. That. Something. I just don't have a hammer. But we have these. And it doesn't seem like these things want to push through. go either way, but we'll encourage it. Nice. Nice encouragement. Okay, so let's just continue. Just giving it a quick little wipe down on the back, and then we'll flip it over and do the same on the front side. You know, this is very superficial, but it's better than nothing. Could really get into a get the fuck cleaning products out, sandpaper. But right now, I'm kind of just gonna get it up kind of mode, not a finishing mode. Maybe later when I'm really feeling of getting into the details of things, we'll sand it. But for now, this works fine, right? Right? Yeah, I think it does. So now, what we're gonna do is bring that over there. And I wanna drill holes in this thing before I put it up to put the screws in. Have it pre-drilled just so there's less chance of it splitting. Thing to do pre-drilling. These screws that I'm using are like maybe a little long, but maybe they're good. So that's about a good thickness, I think, for pre-drilling. So, I brought in another little board right here for this purpose. Under here, just like a sort of thing. So let's measure this. It's approximately 7 inches, so I'm just gonna go a little less than 7 inches. Go 3.3 or maybe. Yeah, 3.5 less. Let's put it just a little bit in from the end. 3.6.3. Right there. Something like that, whatever. So then one approximately in the middle. You can see how I'm really caring about measurements here, and approximately 3.3. And then another one way over here, kind of like right about there, and approximately 3.3. Countertop. And then
Commence drilling!
Oh. Oh, got a little overzealous there. Interesting.
We'll see how that goes. I'm not exactly sure if I got it in the right spot, but...
Well. And the next one, right here. See what it looks like, right? So,
That looked pretty cool.
I think it looked pretty cool, eh? And maybe let's turn off the record light. Let's see what it looks like without the record light on. So neat. It's working. It's doing the things. It's doing it. Right on. So I'm pretty happy with that. And yeah. And if you have any questions about doing this sort of thing, installing these LED strips and making them look cool and work, feel free to ask. I'm into sharing information on such things. Yeah. Also, if say maybe you wanted me to install the custom LED light strips for you, or perhaps create a custom light for you or for a friend as a gift, let me know. I'm into doing such things. Yeah. But I think since we got a color strip LED light strip installed above the workbench and it looks pretty good, I think I'm going to leave you for now, and thank you for tuning in and checking out the Open to Source Tech Zone. We'll turn on the lights there. Yeah. So yeah, thanks for tuning in and checking out the Tech Zone, and let me know if you have any questions, comments, or anything. And if you like what we're doing here and would like to support what we're doing here, creating the videos and sharing the information and releasing things open source, you can go to my website, opentosource.net or opentosource.org, whichever you prefer, and throw a little donation if you feel. So on that note, I'm gonna let you go. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.